Welcome, kids by the sea,
to TNT Bible Story Time, where we have the power of the Holy Spirit. And you do too when you put your trust in Jesus and he gives you that love that he puts into your heart and helps you to follow him even when things are hard. And today we're going to be doing a story that talks about Miss Tricia, wake up.
Keep going.
Well, we're going to be talking about a story about a time when Jesus went to the garden with his disciples and he needed to pray because something really hard was going to happen. Wait, why are you so sleepy today?
It's daylight savings time and we sprung forward, which I don't know what that means because I feel like I'm not sprung forward.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. I kind of feel like I went behind when we did that time change thing.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Makes you really tired. But you know what? It actually reminds me of today's Bible story.
Well, that perks me way up because that makes me happy, but I don't know if it's such a happy story today.
Yeah, you're right, because we've been learning about the last little bit of time that Jesus was on earth before he died and rose again. And last week we talked about the Last Supper that he had with his followers, and it was happy because he wanted to spend time with them and encourage them, but it was sad because he knew what was coming. So tonight we're going to see what happened after he left the dinner table. He went with his disciples into the garden to pray because he had something really hard to do. And I'm wondering, how many of you out there, raise your hand if you guys pray when you have something really hard to do. I do. I'm going to raise my hand and my feet because when I have something really hard, I need Jesus. I need his help. I need the Father God's help. And we're going to see how Jesus prayed to the Father too. And we find it in our Bible. This is our big picture Bible. And we find it in all four Gospels, in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
All four.
All four tell this story. And I'm going to read also from another book that we have, which is our Read and Share Bible. And Miss Trish is going to help me by showing some pictures and some of our other favorite books.
We are going big today.
Yes. This says that Jesus prays for help because we knew he had something hard to do. Jesus and his followers went straight from dinner to a quiet garden. Jesus wanted to pray and ask God to make him strong for what was about to happen. He took three of his closest followers, Peter, James, and John, with him. Jesus asked them to wait and pray. He went a little farther into the garden so that he could pray by himself. It was very late, and the three men were very tired. They couldn't keep their eyes open to pray. Soon they were asleep. Jesus woke them twice, but they went back to sleep each time. Wow. That reminds me of Miss Trisha falling asleep. Yeah. But it also reminds me that when we have really tough things ahead that are coming, that we need to remember to stop and pray and ask God to give us strength for the hard things that we face. So it says the third time, can you show me three fingers? The third time Jesus woke his followers, he said, wake up, wake up. He said, we must go. Here comes the man who has turned against me. One of his friends, one of his very followers that was with him, decided not to follow him anymore. Just then, a big crowd carrying torches and clubs came into the garden. Judas, one of Jesus' followers, was with them. He greeted Jesus, and he gave a signal to the guards to arrest him.
Oh,
no. Peter pulled out his sword, and he tried to hurt one of the guards. Jesus told Peter to put the sword away, and then he healed the guard. Well, you might think that after that, the crowd would let Jesus go because he healed the guard's ear, but they didn't. They arrested him and they took him away anyways. Wow. That's such a hard thing to imagine because Jesus had never done anything wrong. He had loved people and he had never sinned. And if he wanted to call thousands and thousands of angels to his side in that moment, he could have to say, no, don't do this. But when he prayed in the garden, he said, God, this is going to be really hard, Father. And he said, if there's any other way to do it, I would like to do it another way. But if this has to happen, he said, I trust you. I want your will to be done. And he knew in that moment that there wasn't any other way because he was perfect. He's the only one that could pay for all the wrong things anybody has ever done all through history and any mistakes they would ever do in the future. So they took him, and all the chief priests asked him questions, and then they took him to the governor, and they said, lots of people loved Jesus, but there were many who didn't like him at all. And after Jesus was captured in the garden, he was taken to the house of the high priest and then to Pilate, the Roman governor of Judea. All night long, the rulers asked Jesus if he was God's son. They did not believe that he was. So they said, that's called blasphemy. If you say you're the son of God, they didn't believe it was true. They said, we're going to arrest you. They said, finally, Pilate, the Roman leader, he said that he didn't think Jesus did anything wrong and that they should let him go. But the people who did not like Jesus, they kept yelling until Pilate decided that Jesus would be released to them and that he would die on the cross. Jesus told everyone that he was God's son, and that made some people very angry. But even if they didn't believe it, it was true. He was God's son. And that's the reason why he was the only one that was able to come and forgive everybody for all the wrong things that they do and bring them back together with God the Father again. He had so much love for you, your brothers, your sisters, your mom, your dad, your grandmas, your grandpas, Miss Tricia, and me. He loved us so much that he gave his life for us. We're going to see what happens next in our story next week. But these are some hard stories. And I just want to pray and bless you that God would help you and comfort you when you feel sad, and know that you can talk to him too when you have hard things to go through, because he went through hard things for you. Bless the kids, God. You love them so much, Jesus. You said, let the children come to me. I love them. And so I pray that you would do just like Jesus did, that you would pray and that you would come to him with all the hard things that you face, because he loves you so much. We'll see you guys next week. Bye.
Bye.